Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Nahmaduhu wa Nusalli ala Rasulihil Kareem, and welcome back to the countdown. So, continuing with the series on our preparation for the glorious month of Ramadan, we do hope, inshallah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to prepare us for the month of Ramadan, though this will be, alhamdulillah, slightly different for us, at least here in Canada and Toronto. Inshallah, this year we will be allowed to give or grant access to many, to a certain number of people coming to the masajid. Maybe not the same as it was pre-COVID-19, but inshallah, it will be much more different than last year. Having said that, inshallah, we continue now. Today's discussion is on, just like we will be fasting during the month of Ramadan, we will stay away from food and drink. In the same way, we need our hearts to be fasting during the month of Ramadan as well. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reported to have said, "Ala wa inna fil jasadi la mudghah, idha saluhat saluha al jasadu kullu, wa idha fasadat fasada al jasadu kullu." Verily, in the body is a piece of flesh, which, if this piece of flesh is sound, the entire body is sound. And if this piece of flesh is corrupt, the entire body is corrupt. And truly, it, that piece of flesh, is the heart. So we need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, very often, Ya muqallib al-qulub thabbit qalbi ala dinik. O the one who controls the hearts, O the one who sets the heart straight, set my heart on the deen. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked by Abdullah bin Amr radiallahu anhu, O Messenger of Allah, who are the best people? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, Dhul qalb al makhmum wal lisan al saduq. One with a heart swept clean and one who is truthful in speech. So we said, O Messenger of Allah, we know truthful in speech, but what is a heart that is swept clean? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Wat taqiyun naqiyya, la idma fihi wala baghya wala hasad. That heart that is mindful of Allah and pure, in which there is no sin, nor aggression, nor envy. So the Sahaba radiallahu anhum say, we said, who shows a sign of it? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الَّذِي يَشْنَأُ الدُّنْيَا وَيُحِبُّ الْآخِرَةِ. One who hates worldliness and loves the hereafter. They said, and who shows a sign of it? What is a sign that a person hates the dunya, the worldliness, and loves the hereafter? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, مُؤْمِنٌ فِي خُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ, a believer with good character. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with that. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is also reported to have said the hadith of Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, found in Al-Mu'ajim Al-Kabir, الْغِنَى فِي الْقَلْبِ والفقر في القلب من كان الغنى في قلبه لا يضره ما لقي من الدنيا ومن كان الفقر في قلبه فلا يغنيه ما أكثر له في الدنيا وإنما يضر نفسه شحها. Wealth is in the heart and poverty is in the heart. Whoever is wealthy in the heart will not be harmed no matter what happens in the world, and whoever is impoverished in his heart will not be satisfied no matter how much he has in the world. Verily, he will only be harmed by the greed of his own soul. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu reported, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا يبلغ عبد حقيقة الإيمان حتى يحب للناس ما يحب لنفسه من الخير. The servant does not attain the reality of faith, the reality of iman, until he loves for people what he loves for himself of goodness. Going back to what we were discussing yesterday in regards to not harboring any ill feelings towards anyone and cleaning our hearts of all of the malice and animosity and hatred and jealousy towards anyone. This is what we need to practice with our hearts by fasting in the month of Ramadan. Yes, we will be fasting, but we also have to try to clean our hearts and allow our hearts to fast in the same way and remove from our hearts any vices, any evils that have polluted them, anything that is harming us from getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another hadith, Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu reports that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to me, Ya bunayya, in qadarta an tusbiha wa tumsiya laysa fi qalbika ghishun li ahadin faf'al. He said, young man, if you are able morning and evening to remove any rancor from your heart towards anyone, then do so. Don't go to sleep. Don't wake up in the morning. Spend the day with a pure heart, with a clean heart towards everyone. I know this isn't easy. I know sometimes it's very difficult to forgive those who have wronged us. But these are the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify our hearts and clean them before the month of Ramadan. Stay tuned. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.